Wheeled mobile robots employ either conventional wheels, like this unicycle wheel, that do not allow sideways sliding, or wheels that allow sideways sliding through the use of rollers around the rim of the wheel, such as the omniwheel and the mecanum wheel. While it's possible to build omnidirectional mobile robots using conventional wheels by appropriately steering each wheel, often omnidirectional mobile robots are built using unsteered omniwheels or mecanum wheels. I'll focus on robots using omniwheels and mecanum wheels in this video. This image shows a mobile robot with three omniwheels. This is a schematic top view of the robot. Each wheel is controlled by driving the wheel forward or backward, and it's assumed that the wheels do not slip or skid in the driving direction. The rollers on the wheel allow free sliding of the wheel in the orthogonal direction. This mobile base has four mecanum wheels, which do not slip in the driving direction, but allow free sliding at an angle of 45 degrees relative to the driving direction. The principle behind the omniwheel and the mecanum wheel is the same, but they differ in the direction they allow free sliding. This video addresses the following question. Given a desired chassis velocity, what should the driving speeds of the wheels be? To answer that question, let's focus on a single wheel and develop a model that applies to omniwheels or mecanum wheels. First, we define a frame B fixed to the robot's chassis. The center of wheel I is at XI, YI, and its forward driving direction, the direction it rolls without slipping, is at an angle beta I relative to the XB axis. The rollers around the rim of the wheel allow free sliding at an angle gamma I relative to the direction perpendicular to the driving direction. Gamma I is 0 degrees for an omniwheel and 45 degrees for a mecanum wheel. With these definitions, we can calculate the wheel driving speed UI, which is the rotational speed of the motor attached to the wheel. We'll build up to the result. First, we define the linear velocity at the center of the wheel, as indicated by the vector shown in green. This is the sum of the driving velocity and the free sliding velocity. This linear velocity is derived from the body twist VB, and it depends on the position of the wheel in the B frame. We then transform this linear velocity to a frame fixed to the wheel. This linear velocity is the vector sum of the driving velocity and the free sliding velocity, so we can decompose the wheel velocity into its sliding velocity and driving velocity components. A little geometry shows that the driving component can be calculated by taking the dot product of the wheel velocity with the vector 1 tangent gamma I. Finally, to convert the linear driving velocity to a rotational speed for the wheel, we divide by Ri, where Ri is the radius of the wheel. The final result is a 1 by 3 rho vector times the twist, Vb. We call this rho vector Hi, and more specifically Hi of 0, for reasons that will become clear shortly. We can stack the Hi rho vectors for the M wheels to create an M by 3 matrix called H of 0. Then the vector of wheel velocities for a given chassis twist is calculated as u equals h of 0 times vb. This procedure only works if h of 0 is full rank, or rank 3. We can apply this kinematic modeling to a robot with three omniwheels at the corners of a triangle. The H matrix is 3 by 3, as shown here. R is the radius of the wheels, and d is the distance of the wheels from the center of the triangle. We can also apply our modeling to a robot with four mecanum wheels. The wheels are configured so that their sliding directions are not all aligned. This is necessary for the H matrix to be full rank. The H matrix is 4 by 3, as shown here. The length L is the X distance from the B frame to the wheels, and the width W is the Y distance from the B frame to the wheels. The fact that this matrix is not square means that an arbitrary choice of wheel speeds will cause skidding of the wheels in the drive direction. To avoid skidding, the wheel speeds must be chosen on a three-dimensional surface in the four-dimensional wheel speed space, as determined by the H matrix. This is unlike the three omniwheel robot, where we can choose the wheel speeds arbitrarily without causing skidding. Let's use the H matrix to drive a robot with four mecanum wheels. The H matrix tells us that forward-backward motion in the body X direction requires all wheels to have the same speed, as shown in this animation. If the desired motion is a pure rotation in the body frame, the wheels on the same side should have the same speed. If the desired motion is sideways in the body Y direction, then wheels on opposite corners should have the same speed. In summary, the wheel speeds equal the H of 0 matrix times the twist VB, provided H of 0 is full rank. Sometimes it's convenient to calculate the wheel speeds in terms of Q dot, the rate of change of the coordinates phi, x, and y. To do this, we replace VB by a rotation matrix times Q dot, where the rotation matrix transforms Q dot to VB. We call H of 0 times the rotation matrix the matrix H of phi, giving us the relationship U equals H of phi times Q dot. With our kinematic modeling of omnidirectional robots complete, in the next video I'll address motion planning and control.